All right. Where your face should mask. I try it? Okay. Where here goes nothing. Yeah. One, two, three.
Subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon.
And what is up, my guys? Christian Reyes here. Welcome to 2020, boys, in which the year started on fire.
Some 130 fires are burning right now.
At least 4 people are missing, and at least 24 are dead.
Murder hornets invaded our airspace.
In its native Asia, Vespa mandarinia is notorious. Tracked one down in Japan via how to fight an alien predator like this.
Then, I was forced into quarantine. Now, I'm sure you all know that there's a deadly virus, aka the Big Rona, sweeping the world by storm. And if you don't know what that is, then I'm deeply jealous of you because you probably live in a developed country whose government body believes in science and took the necessary precautions to cleanse the virus. Or you're just blissfully unaware of the current world crisis. Either way, I envy you. So, I currently live in the United States where things aren't looking too pretty at the moment. We've only recently officially mandated wearing masks to protect ourselves and others as recommended by WHO and CDC. Now, I really don't want to turn this into a political issue, which is how we got into this problem in the first place. But I will say that I myself am following these guidelines and hope that others will too. I've noticed that while going around doing my errands that many people are forgetting their masks. Being a good citizen I am, I decided to put my skills into practice and create the robot that will help people to remember to wear their mask before they leave their homes. I'm using a Raspberry Pi as an IP camera to transmit images to my computer and determine whether a person is wearing a face mask. I'm using YOLO V4. YOLO is short for You Only Look Once. It is a real-time object detection system that can easily recognize objects in an image. To have a good and reliable object detection model, I found this great dataset, which is a collection of sample images of people with face masks, people who are trying their best, and people with no regard for human life. Okay, now that our dataset has been trained, we can go ahead and test it out. Now, as you can see, I am not wearing any mask and it has like 99% of accuracy. Now I'm going to take a mask and try to wear it. Now, as you can see, this is with mask. Now, what if I don't wear it properly? So if I were to wear it like this, it says mask worn improperly. Now, if I wear it back, looks good. Now that the model is trained to our liking, RESTful API requests are then sent back to Raspberry Pi, where a sound notification is played to remind the person to wear his mask. Alright, now I have set an audio file that which will play if you are not wearing a mask or if you wear a mask but not properly. So, let us open the program again and see how it looks.
You wear your face mask.
And there we go. That's because I am not wearing a mask right now. So it says, yo,
wear your face mask.
Wear your face mask.
You.
Now, what if I cover my face or say if I get off the frame?
You.
So let's do something like this.
Wear your face mask. You. Wear your face mask.
All right, it works. And now, let us try, what if
you wear your face mask?
I wear my mask.
Wear your
so let's
face
try
mask.
To wear it improperly
you
first.
Wear your
so.
Face mask. You wear your face mask. You.
And then if I
mask.
Wear it properly.
You wear your face mask. You wear your face mask.
And it should not play the notification anymore, which is great. But just reminding someone to wear their mask isn't going to work. We can see an evidence of this by watching the news or literally just walking outside. If people aren't going to follow the federal law, then what's gonna make them follow a sound notification from an inanimate object? So, what's the best way to remind people to wear their mask? We can refer to our boy Boris Frederick Skinner and his research about operant conditioning. You've probably heard of a little thing called negative reinforcement. Basically, the general idea of negative conditioning is using a negative stimulus every time that the person is not expressing the behavior we're looking for. The result should be a more positive reaction. Like for example, people will wear their mask. In other words, I just need a reason to tase people. So, back to my drawing board. I'm adding a taser machine with its electrodes attached to the doorknob to electrocute whoever dares to open the door with no face mask on. Alright, so what I got here right now is I've hooked up this relay board to this Raspberry Pi, which acts like a switch to this taser machine. So what it does is when someone is detected not wearing a mask or detected wearing a mask but improperly, it then closes the circuit, activates the taser, thus electrocuting the person. As you can see or may have heard, these relays click. This is meant to resemble that your taser is turning on or off on intervals. And this is what it looks like with your taser in action. This feature enables a person to let go of the doorknob and regret even trying. Why though? Because the purpose of this project is to save lives by making people wear their mask and not end up dancing with these legends with electrocution as their cause of death. Once I wear my face mask on, taser deactivates and sound notification also disappears. And I am given 10 seconds to get off the frame while I open the door, close, and leave. Once the countdown is finished, it is back again into tasing people when no mask is on.
Face mask.
And alright boys, this is the full project. Just a quick recap. This camera is connected to Raspberry Pi, which continuously transmits images to this computer. It determines whether I'm wearing a face mask or not, wherein API calls are then sent back to Raspberry Pi, which plays the sound notification while the taser is activated. And oh boy, those sparks are so good to look at. All right guys, so we got a visitor. Let's see how my robot does.
Bye-bye.
You, wear
what
your
was
face
that?
Mask. Wear your face mask.
Wear my face mask.
Yeah, wear your face mask
your face
or get
mask.
Electrocuted.
Oh,
wear
yes,
your face
I know.
Mask. You, wear your face mask.
Hey, okay, you touch it.
Ayoko
nang hawakan. I don't even wanna touch it. No, you open it.
Wala na.
No. I wanna go home.
Go.
Okay na ako. Ayaw mo nang pakita dito.
And for clever people out there who think they can avoid facing the camera and trick the system, well, think again. You see this thing right here that goes in and out? This is called a latch bolt. Since it is made out of steel, it can conduct electricity, bridging a circuit from this whole doorknob assembly to this strike plate. I've put a grounding mechanism in the latch assembly, which acts like a switch, so that whenever the latch bolt is pulled by twisting the doorknob, it activates the taser to electrocute you during the attempt at opening the door. Alright, should I try it? Okay, here goes nothing. 1, 2, 3, ah! Woo! This hurts so bad. And that is it. Thanks everyone for watching. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And most importantly, also please don't forget to wear your mask and stand 6 feet away from me at all times. Not because I'm worried about coronavirus, but just because I hate people. But in all seriousness though, please remember to wear your masks. This is honestly a big issue right now, and it shouldn't be really hard to wear your mask and protect your fellow humans. The more people comply with these rules, the easier for us to get back to a normal life. In any case, if you guys have any more suggestions for ideas that I may build, leave them in the comments. Until next time, catch you guys later.